गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे स्टार्ट विद द एक्सर्जी, ए मेजर ऑफ वर्क पोटेंशियल. सो व्हाट इज एक्सर्जी? द इंक्रीज अवेयरनेस दैट द वर्ल्ड एक्सर्जी एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज आर लिमिटेड हैज कॉज मेनी कंट्रीज टू रिकॉग्नाइज देयर एनर्जी पॉलिसीज एंड टेक ड्रास्टिक मेजर्स टू एलिमिनेट वेस्ट मीन्स इट हैज ऑल्सो स्पार्क इंटरेस्ट इन द साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी टू टेक ए क्लोजर लुक एट द एनर्जी कन्वर्जन डिवाइसेज एंड टू डेवलप ए न्यू टेक्निक्स टू बेटरलाइज utilize the existing limiting sources. The first law of thermodynamics deals with the quantity of energy and asserts that energy cannot be created or destroyed. This law merely serves as a necessary tool for bookkeeping of energy during a process and offers no challenge to the engineer. The second law, however, deals with the quality of energy. More especially, it is concerned with the degradation of energy during a process, the entropy generation, and the loss of opportunities to do work, and it offers plenty of room for improvement. The second law of thermodynamics has proved to be a very powerful tool in the optimization of complex thermodynamic systems. In this chapter, we examine the performance of engineered devices in light of second law of thermodynamics. We start our discussions with the introduction of exergy, also called availability, which is the maximum useful work that could be obtained from the system at a given state in a specified environment. And we continue with the reversible work, which is the maximum useful work that can be obtained as the system undergoes a process between two specific states. So in this chapter, we examine the performance of engineered devices in light of second law of thermodynamics, define exergy, which is the maximum useful work that could be obtained from the system at a given state in specific environment, define reversible work, which is the maximum useful work that can be obtained as a system undergoes a process between two specific states, define the exergy destruction, which is the wasted work potential during a process as a result of irreversibilities, define the second law efficiency, develop the exergy balance relation, apply exergy balance to closed systems and control volume. Exergy, which is the work potential of energy, when a new energy source such as geothermal well is discovered, the first thing the explorer do is to estimate the amount of energy contained in source. The information alone, however, is of little value in deciding whether to build a power plant on the site. Means if you had energy source, you have to decide you can extract that energy into useful work or not will depend on number of factors. What we really need to know is the work potential of the source, that is the amount of energy we can extract as useful work. Energy is already available in the environment, but that is not useful for us. Means air is already available at 25 degrees Celsius temperature and 1 atmosphere pressure. But can we convert that energy into useful work? No. So why it's no, and why you can convert the energy like in power plant? What is the reason? The rest of energy is eventually discarded as waste energy and is not worthy of our consideration. Thus, it would be very desirable to have a property to enable us to determine the useful work potential of a given amount of energy at some specific state. This property is exergy, which is also called the availability or available energy. The work potential of energy contained in a system at a specific state is simply the maximum useful work that can be obtained from the system. You will recall that work done during a process depends on initial state, final state, and process path. Means work is equal to function of initial state, what has final state, and what process you had to follow to extract that work. In an exergy analysis, the initial state is specified and thus it is not a variable. The work output is maximum when the process between two specific states is executed in a reversible manner. Therefore, all irreversibilities are disregarded and determining the work potential. Finally, the system must be in a dead state at the end of process. Means during extraction of the work, system is at initial state. After the extraction of work, the system will go to the final state, which is you can say also called dead state. What is dead state? A state of the system from where you can't extract any amount of work. A system is said to be a dead state when it is in thermodynamic equilibrium with surrounding. Means when your system has achieved equilibrium with the surrounding, at that point of time you can't able to extract work. Means during expansion, at the end of expansion stroke, when the pressure within the cylinder is almost near to the surrounding, it is not possible to expand the gases beyond that point. So it means whatever gases, from gases you had extracted the energy, and now gases are at dead state, means they are in equilibrium with the surrounding environment. At the dead state, a system is at temperature. At dead state, system is at temperature and pressure of its surrounding in thermal and mechanical equilibrium. It has no kinetic or potential energy relative to the environment, means zero velocity and zero elevation above a reference level, and it does not react with the environment, chemically inert. Also, there are no unbalanced magnetic, electrical and surface tension effects between the system and its surrounding. If these are relevant to the situation at hand, the properties of a system at dead state are denoted by subscript 0. For example, P0 is the dead state pressure, T0 is dead state pressure, and this is taken as, you can say, your atmosphere temperature pressure, which is at room temperature 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmospheric. Now we'll take the example of a potato here. You can see there are three things. One is the hot potato, which is your system. Second is your immediate surrounding, which is around the potato, and third is your environment. So by definition, surrounding are everything outside the system, means that this is your system, and outside the system, whatever it is surrounding, but surrounding is further divided into immediate surrounding and this surrounding. So the immediate surrounding refers to the portion of the surrounding that is affected by process, and the environment refers to the region beyond the immediate surrounding whose properties are not affected by the process at any point. Therefore, any irreversibilities during a process occur within the system and its immediate surrounding, and the environment is free of any irreversibilities. When analyzing the cooling of a hot baked potato in a room, for example, the warm air that surrounds the potato is the immediate surrounding, and the remaining part of the room, air at 25 degrees Celsius, is the environment. Note that the temperature of the immediate surrounding change from the temperature of the potato at the boundary to the environment temperature at 25 degrees Celsius. The notion that a system must go to dead state at the end of the process to maximize the work output can be explained as follows. If the system temperature at the final state is greater than or less than the temperature of the environment it is in, we can always produce additional work by running a heat engine between these two temperature levels. If the final pressure is greater or less than the pressure of the environment, we can still obtain work by letting the system expand to the pressure of the environment. Means if we have temperature difference, we can obtain the work. If we have pressure difference, still we can obtain the work. So if the final velocity of system is not zero, we can catch that extra kinetic energy by a turbine and convert it to rotating shaft work. Means at the exit of turbine, if still you had a velocity, you can use a turbine and you can expand that gas. You can convert the kinetic energy of that gas, high velocity gas, to the work with the help of turbine. So no work can be produced from a system that is initially at dead state. But if the system is at dead state, means it is in equilibrium with the environment, you can't produce any work. You can take example of this atmosphere. The atmosphere contains a tremendous amount of energy, but no exergy, means there is no chance that we can obtain work from the atmosphere because it is in the equilibrium state, or you can say dead state. Therefore, we conclude that a system delivers the maximum possible work as it undergoes a reversible process from a specified initial state to the of its environment, that is a dead state. Means for the work to be maximum, or you can say for exergy, maximum exergy is defined as when your system will give you work from, it will go from initial state, and the final state should be the your dead state, which is here specified as 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere pressure. So this represents the useful work potential of system at a specific state and is called exergy. Means the maximum possible work as it undergoes a reversible process from a specified initial state to the state of the environment. It is important to realize that exergy does not represent the amount of work that a work producing device will actually deliver upon installation. Rather, it represents the upper limit on the amount of work a device can deliver without violating any thermodynamic laws. There will always be a difference, large or small, between exergy and the actual work delivered by a device. This difference represents the room engineers have for improvement. Means whatever the difference between the exergy and the actual work we are producing now, so this will make us some chances that we can improve the whatever work we are getting with the existing devices. Note that the exergy of a system at a specified state depends on conditions of environment, that is the state, as well as the properties of the system. Therefore, exergy is a property of system, environment, combination, and not of the system alone. Altering the environment is another way of increasing exergy, but it is definitely not an easy alternative. The term availability was made popular in the United States by MIT School of Engineering in 1940, and today an equivalent term, exergy, introduced in Europe in 1950, has found global acceptance partially because it is shorter, energy and entropy, and it can be adapted without requiring translation. So in this text we had discussed about the exergy. Now we'll discuss with the exergy, which is work potential associated with kinetic and potential energy. Kinetic energy is a form of mechanical energy, and thus it can be converted to work entirely, means we can convert all the kinetic energy into work. Therefore, the work potential or exergy of a kinetic energy of a system is equal to the kinetic energy itself, regardless of the temperature and pressure of the environment. So, exergy of a kinetic energy is equal to kinetic energy itself, it means V2 square by 2 for per unit mass. Potential energy is also a form of mechanical energy, and thus it can be also converted into work. Suppose you have a water in a dam at high altitude. It has this much amount of potential energy, suppose mgz. So you can convert this all energy into the work, and regardless of temperature and pressure of the environment. So therefore, the exergy of the potential energy of a system is equal to the potential energy itself regardless of the temperature. So exergy in this case is equal to exergy of potential energy is equal to potential energy itself, or Gz per unit mass, where G is gravitational acceleration and Z is elevation of the system. Therefore, exergies of kinetic and potential energies are equal to themselves, and they are entirely available for work. However, internal energy U and enthalpy H of a system are not entirely available for work. We will discuss it later. Reversible work and irreversibility. The property exergy serves as a valuable tool in determining the quality of energy and comparing the work potentials of different energy sources or system. For example, take the example of this closed system. A closed system expands. Some work needs to be done to push the atmosphere air out of the way. So when the piston will move up, so this is atmosphere pressure of air. So when your piston moves from this position to this position, so it has to do some work on the atmosphere surrounding air, which we can't, you can say, get from the back from the surrounding. During the movement of the piston in this direction, surrounding does not transfer this work back to the system. So that work is lost to the atmosphere. So work surrounding is equal to pressure of surrounding into this final volume minus initial volume, means this change in volume. So this work is the work which we lost in case of this closed system. So in this section we describe two quantities that are related to the actual, initial and final state of process, and serve as a valuable tool in the thermodynamics analysis of the components of surrounding. These two quantities are reversible work and irreversibility. So the difference between the actual work and the surrounding work is called useful work. So you can see here the work actually is equal to the is the difference between the your actual work and work of surrounding. This will give you the useful work. So this useful work is always less in case of as compared to the because some work is has lost. So when a system is expanding and doing work, part of the work is used to overcome the atmosphere pressure, and does work surrounding represent a loss. When a system is compressed, however, the atmosphere pressure helps the compression process, and does W surrounding represent a gain. Note that the work done or against the atmosphere pressure has significance only for system whose volume changes during the process. It has no significance for cyclic devices system whose boundaries remain fixed during a process, such as rigid tanks and steady flow devices, turbine, compressor, nozzles, heat exchangers. So this is up to here. Next class we will discuss, next video we will discuss next topic. Subscribe this channel, like this video, and thank you for watching this video.